give them back all of their concepts and set the concept of belief and fact on what you have experienced. Now, if you have never seen a flying saucer, don't believe anybody who says they have, including me, until you have the experience. Now, you say, well, Pop, I love you. I want to trust you. Thank you. But don't bet on it. Only on the things I confirm for you. Now, you may say, well, man, since 1970, you've been teaching us and predicting events and all that happened. So more than likely, the next thing you say is going to happen. Fine. That's your own conviction. I am not going to tell you to believe in flying saucers if you haven't seen it. Who here has seen a flying saucer with their own eyes? See, some of us have. Some of y'all haven't. So we sound crazy. I think they're men, but they have no apparent sexual organs. With big heads. Some grayish or brownish in complexion, with large eyes and little slits. Some had five fingers, some had four. Some had three, some had like claws, which means there's some type of mutation or evolution or graftation or genetic experiment going on amongst them also. But millions of people all over the world, not just crazy people, scientists, doctors, reverends, policemen, what else? Military presidents, Carter, our Georgia boy, confirmed he saw a UFO. And so did Reagan, and so did Kennedy, and so did Truman, and so did your boy Elvis Presley, and so did Jimi Hendrix, and so did Marvin Gaye. There's a whole book of all the stars that saw them. You listen to their music and cry with them and make love to them. But when they say, I believe in a UFO, oh, he raises it up. Marvin Gaye says, what's going on? Save the children. I love that. I believe in a UFO. Whoop, the boy crazy. What are the chances of people all over the world speaking a different language who've never come in contact with each other having the same experience? What are the chances? All these people got together and conspired? Why? Is the question. Why? What would be the reason? Why would a guy in Germany and a guy in Mexico have the exact same story? Pardon me. The exact same story. What? How? In Puerto Rico, Chupacabra. How? And all these people in Puerto Rico is crazy, right? Farmers, villages who have no interest in the public or the media say, yeah, I saw one run by. A bloodsucker, it called. But y'all who haven't had the experience, look at us, call us crazy. We wonder why you haven't had the experience. Let me see them hands again. The ones who have had the experience, some type of UFO or phenomenon. I'm saying, you know, quite a few of us have. And it's frightening. Because when I was a little kid, and my sister's probably sitting here right now somewhere, she'll tell you, when I was a little kid, I used to disappear for weeks. That's what's sitting right back there. Is that true? What did y'all used to do? Tell the truth. Give up mics and keep going. Then you beat the hell out of me. Want to hear it? Hey, just go up and be a witness. What would y'all do?
When you came back, you were spanking.
A spanking, they go.
Okay, when he was disappeared, we didn't know what happened to him. We'd come back, he would have, like, heavy nosebleeds and stuff like that. And he was, as a kid then, saying that he was abducted. And we were like, yeah, right. And he was, this is true, believe me. And he was a little kid, not knowing anything about this. There was no TV, no media about abductions and stuff like that. And this is what.
Don't tell him that tells how old I am. No TV. No TV. Him and Jesus were sitting on the couch about to tell you again. It's real. And those of us who had the real experiences and suffered the traumas of it all our lives, it ain't no joke to us. Y'all people here who doesn't say, well, I wish somebody would abduct me. They do two things. They abduct and they abduct it. These women that said they took me on a ship and they saw that I was so attractive that they wanted to have my baby, so they did it to me. Right? Then there's other people say they took me up there, they experimented on me, they were sticking tubes in my head and stuff, and then I don't know what happened after that. There's other people say they sat down and told me I'm special, and they're going to take me off to heaven with them. What are some of the other ones? Anybody got any of them?
They will tell your world that they messed them up.
They said to inform the world that you human beings are messing up and you better turn around and change things before it's too late. Right?
Yep.
What else? Anybody else?
People come back with metallic objects in them and stuff.
Yeah. Say again, bro?
People come back with metallic like objects all over their
I have one of those. Look in here. That's where the blood came from. Huh?
Showing signs of the future.
They sometimes project a screen for you to see. Like they do me, and I can foresee things are going to come in hundreds of years, and I come tell y'all, and then they come back, and then y'all still say, it's crazy. Who else? Do you know how many of them are walking on the planet Earth as human beings? Passing themselves off as humans? Mixing into the society of man? Not only good ones. They want to use humans for food, some of them. Don't feel bad. Chickens feel that way about you. You just another part of the chain of life. You sit down and eat a curry goat. How do you think goats feel? You got them locked in your yard inside a gate. Raise them to kill them, to cut them, to eat them. And then when a couple of y'all get abducted and some extra treasures put you somewhere and raise y'all to cut you, to eat you, maybe they don't curry you or barbecue, they might got some other term they use, you feel like, yeah, that ain't right. Almost everybody on television says the same thing. It ain't right. You just can't do that to people. Isn't that what they say? That's not right. They just came to my bed, woman took me out and just did things to me. Some people liked it, some people hated it. Have you ever waited for the exit dressing every night? But it is happening. And don't let anybody fool you into thinking, because you haven't been abducted yet, that it's not happening. It is happening. Yes?
Brother, I have a question. What is more like advice? But 3 weeks ago, I experienced a ringing in my ear. I get them frequently, but this one was, like, intense. And now I can't hear, or it's like pressure is in my left ear. I was wondering, have anyone come to you?
All the time. You have a hole in your ear?
Yes.
Both of them or one?
One on the right.
On the right ear? Okay, go ahead.
It's like I'm afraid. Cause
don't be afraid.
I don't want to go to the doctor.
Don't be afraid. The doctors can't tell you nothing. That ring in your ear is alignment. People with holes in their ear over here, some have one, some have two. Those are people that are going, I'm trying to think of another word for it. I can't think of anything else other than the word counselor. When the elders come, when God comes, right, and the voice of God is spoken, it's going to be in sound, not in language. And these people who are being aligned are going to be the ones that tell people where to go. Those are chosen people, and they will be sent. They'll hear voices in their head. Now, some people hear voices in their head now and end up in a nut house. But the reality of that is that it's a fact that people can hear voices in their head. You understand my point? The fact that doctors will put people in the hospital and put them on certain types of medication, because doctors have come to the conclusion that yes, certain people do hear voices in their head. Wait, Bon?
Yes.
Yes, they do. Yes. And have went out and killed people, but the voice has said, go kill somebody. Say it again? And they'll blame it on Tupac. There you go. Remember that one, right? You know, this is the reality. Go ahead.
And they camouflage into human beings. Right?
They're people. No. They're beings that are descending to earth, extraterrestrials, disagreeables. Right? in the form of human beings, not descending into human beings. They won't come in to take your body. They're not walking. They are actually people that are here on Earth, like heads of record companies, heads of the movies, controlling the lives of many people. I'm not gonna say Michael Jackson, because everybody wants me to say Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson is a confused nigga. But yeah.
All right. What I was trying to lead to was, just suppose that you can see these beings that are camouflaging themselves. What is happening to you?
They're not camouflaging themselves, Sam, but they're walking around every day with you. I can point out some of them. The guy comes on television all the time. He teaches all the stars about how to make money and all that. You can see he's a Veneri. About almost 7 feet tall. Oh, he's an extra brother. The whole lot is giving names. So many of them out there now, and they are controlling the lives. L. Ron Hubbard. Yeah, control, Dianetics, these are organizations, the Scientology movement. These are groups of extraterrestrials from the Pleiades or Aldebaran or Ashtar Command that's incarnated here and are staring people down a certain direction. And they become extremely numb.
Now, when religion expired, an extraterrestrial came in, and it was a flood of UFOs, abductions, sightings, etc. They had a first encounter, second encounter, third encounter. They started putting numbers in our ears. Everything got to be logged and numbered. The third encounter. What they had to do, they realized that people, intelligent people, were going to come back to the institutions, namely the churches and the mosques, and start having questions about the UFOs. You follow? And they want to sustain their belief in the rapture, that some god or gods are coming to get them the hell out of here when the stuff gets too dark. So the first thing they did is the only substantiated or confirmed UFO sighting, they say, comes out of Switzerland. They say a guy named Myers, one arm, right, who's a farmer way out on the hills of nowhere, took actual pictures of flying saucers. You know what I mean? They call it the Myers thing. And they verify, oh, we cannot prove these are wrong. And while all you people are going, okay, and they're real flying saucers, there's another chapter to what they add. And what happened, Myers, Billy Myers? Well, what happened is, one day I was out in the field, and I saw a crab. I ran back and got my camera, and I set it up and I started taking pictures. Lo and behold, this crab landed not far from me. So as an inquisitive man, I walked towards the crab, and the crab opened up. And out stepped this tall, beautiful woman, Nordic, blonde hair, blue eyes. She was the most beautiful woman I ever saw, he said. I knew right away she was from another planet. He even has a name, I forgot what he called her. You understand what I'm saying, though? And then the next minute, her and two guys came out. Two men stepped out. They were tall, blonde hair, blue eyes, muscular. They were Nordic. And they told us that the planet is about to destroy itself, and that we are your God. And we came here to warn y'all, to prepare y'all, to guide y'all, so you won't destroy the planet. And they took me, he said, and put me on a craft and took me to another star system where I saw all these people look alike. How they look, y'all? And they lived in peace and harmony. It was a beautiful thing. And he said, this is how we're supposed to live. And I got to go back. You have to go back and teach them this. You understand? And Billy Myers comes back and put all these little pictures and spine sources. NASA looks at him and says, we can't prove they're wrong. I can't. I can prove they're wrong, because he says, I'm watching these on the screen, and he says, they go interdimensionally and out. That's what he shows. He shows them, some of y'all saw it, they boop in and boop out. In my mind, in my knowledge there, I see aerodynamics there. Because when I see a flying saucer, you know what they call a flying saucer? There it is now. Okay, go. That's good. What they call what they call a flying saucer is actually two saucers put together that are shaped in a way that makes it possible for them to stick through our atmosphere without any resistance, no G-force. Because a flat object, as I keep explaining to you, moving through our atmosphere at a certain Brazil and Argentina and made connections with America. That's when Ali Norton then was at when he was selling crap, like Argentina. And they'll tell you Argentina, they're nothing but Germans. They took the technology there, that's where Einstein and all of them used to meet. Tesla, Einstein, Vaughn Newman. They had crap, they were flying crafts around. These are things flying around here, but what's the problem? The problem is there are crafts coming in and out, cylinder-shaped crafts, tuba-shaped crafts. They are not aerodynamic, and they ain't able to catch them because they're jumping dimensionally. They only pop for a second and out. So you come up with this Roswell thing, one of the flying saucers cracked. That makes it real. And NASA says, nah, we can't prove that it didn't crash, but we won't say it did. That makes it believable. Then they come up with autopsy of a UFO. They say, looks real. Can't prove that it's not real. It has six fingers on it, though. Now they show you in this Bible where they've got people that have six fingers and six toes. So anybody knows the Bible goes, maybe there's some kind of biblical creature. Maybe that's the biblical. So they start to open the doorway to let biblical seep back in, because that's the best spell they got us under, religion. And then when we started finding out about some possible beings coming from somewhere else, they got scared that we would give up their religious crap. They got very scared. So they had to recreate religion inside the UFO phenomenon. They had to get a new Jesus. A new Nordic image for us, a new savior. You follow? And thus they come up with this Billy Myers crap, blonde and blue-eyed Nordics coming to save you. And New Orleans are believing, joining their little organization. And it's nothing but a prototype or an overlay of the same Christian concept. Then they go back and say, well, Hitler, he was exposed to the owls of Aryans. And when they describe them, they say, tall, blonde and blue-eyed Nordic people. Ashtar Command. Tall, long hair, blue eyed, Nordic people. And they're coming to save us. You follow what I'm saying? Here we are, back in the church. Back in the church with a white God.
Yes, I forgot where I read it, but there's sulfur balls down in like South America. They're going to use to like set the earth afire. Saying this correct? Are they going to hit the whole earth or just parts of it or what?
All about the balls in South America. It's not the whole planet. It will never ever be destroyed. You know, just designated places where what they're talking about now is the meteorites coming here in May. We know everybody's talking about that. Those meteorites seem to be kind of strange to have happened right after they talked about a large amount of UFO appearances on Gulf Breeze that they seem to suppress because they want to make him look crazy. You know, the government has already proven that didn't exist, and they were sending dummies down, etc. And they're trying to take advantage because there's been a lot of UFO sightings followed by the scientists revealing that there may have been life discovered on Mars by minute bacteria that they found on the Mars rock. And NASA, and we know the fears, of course, us questioning the stability of the government we live in and losing faith in a government that we must trust in order to survive. So we do hear rumors that meteorites are coming, and then Art Bell is saying that those meteorites coming are coming from the craft that was near Hellbach. And that's what he said at his radio station. And that kind of reaches across from here to California. That, you know, everybody's talking about an opinion as if it's a fact. You know what I'm saying? Now the rumor is that the planet will be caught on fire in May. Or that's the shower, or the large meteorite is coming in November. One either or the others will hit us, and the United States government and Russia and all of them are involved in this project of detouring it away from Earth. And that the same balls you're talking about are supposed to be the weapons used by these extraterrestrials that they've now confirmed are no longer agreeable. That was the Belgian contact. A triangle-shaped craft, they've come to the conclusion that the occupants of those crafts are not pro-Earth, but rather planning on being destructive, and that those are the doomsday gods. And they're talking about the ancient Sumeria, the ancient Celtics, talk about the ancient Hopi, talk about the doomsday gods who are bringing the thunders of destruction to the earth. And they're saying that those same balls are not will be used as weapons, but the kind of weapons. Those were from the previous attack to earth. It destroyed the dinosaurs, and they say the meteorite was actually an attack, they say.
So that's not saying those balls will be lifted up so much as those kind of balls are the ones that will be launched at Earth again. And it won't be all over the planet. It'll just be a designated place. But, you know, it's kind of funny because meanwhile they're telling us about natural calamities. And you would think that the extraterrestrials who have been monitoring us for so long would also be able to see the tidal waves. And they'd also be able to see the hurricanes. And they'd also be able to see the weather climatic change and the global warming and the insect population. They would think they'd be wise enough after all these thousand years to just say, hell, let's wait a couple more years. They're going to destroy themselves any damn way. Why throw rocks so we can sit there looking? So, you know, because of media and the way it manipulates our minds, we're in a very strange situation because they throw out so many things and so many kind of beliefs that, in other words, they're programming us to believe something.
Beings who came here from a planet in the Sirius or Sirius star complex, which is called Zeta in ancient Egypt, or Ilium to others, who came here and came from a planet where there was soil, where they walked around on the ground. Yeah? And they had to hover above the water until they could prepare a planet for them to step down on it. Just like they did with Noah. See, the Noah or Noah, or with the Vishnu story, is showing you again, that's why you see that all the makings of the Adam story, that they were in the boat and had to check to make sure dry land came so they could come back out. So otherwise they would step out of the ground. They were telling you the same story about the old rival. Yeah? That they had to come and create the environment so that they can step down out of the craft on dry. Right? When they stepped down onto this dry land, they called it Adama. Adama. And that's the word for ground. Adama. When they set up their colonies, they called this place Iridu. A home away from home. And Iridu, 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 was bred out of that meaning. Earth, they know when they say it, is a Sumerian term used by beings who are saying by saying it, this is a home away from home. I don't really stay here. I came here for the Adama Project. And that is to seed with reptilians and breed a hybrid. A fisherman or a seaman.
Been listening to Dr. Malachi Z. York classic recordings from one of the many schools of thought. The truth for all Muslims, Christians, Hebrews, Jews. The time is now. Make your way to the nearest All Eyes on Egypt bookstore near you.
Eisenhower came forth and publicly announced, and he showed pictures I got the thing. Right? He came forth, and they showed him with present eyes now, and he said, yes, we are living in a time where UFOs do exist. He was there at Roswell, he said. He looked in the box, he said, Gray's in there. They told the story on that same program about how the extraterrestrials were here, making a deal with Eisenhower in there. Right? And gave them technology. Talk about the lasers and mini discs and certain medical cures. They have it all on the tape. So I on the tape, I'm gonna put it on for y'all so we get it in. Right, you know? And then when they decided to leave, the government said, we want y'all to give us the technology on your craft. And this was Truman. They told him no. They said Truman first, and then Eisenhower after, I'm sorry. They told him no, we won't give it to you. You know what they did? Shot the craft down. The craft bounced down in Roswell, New Mexico, and then picked up and tried to take off and then crashed again about 60 miles away. This is the man said. Now you go back and read our book, From Man from Planet Rift, and you see the exact same story. He said certain students came around and saw on the floor four dead Grays, one badly wounded, and one walking around dazed, asking for help but without talking. This is Dwight David Eisenhower, right-hand man, saying, you know what he heard before? He said, all I want, because he's old now, he's old and in the sea of creation, right? So he don't care anymore, they can't do nothing to him. He said, all I want the government to do is be fair and tell the people the truth. Let them know we are in contact with UFOs. They're all graves here. He said, that's all I want. These lies have to stop. Now, anybody wants to remember, the only mentality that must fight reality is faith, belief, and theory. And that's the foundation for religion. So people on the religious tip got to make like this is not true, because if you say, show me the graves in your Bible, they can't. And it makes them look stupid for believing a certain philosophy their whole life, but they have no proof of it. You know what I'm saying? But now they have come to the conclusion. Oh man, they just showed, I'm saying, if they had to say it, it would come on at 9 and stayed on to 11. How many hours? Huh? For a whole week. They just showed, they showed stuff that you haven't seen before. They went back to everything in UFOs and they showed you all the things that were not confirmed. All the things the government couldn't right away. Oh, they also said, yes, the Majestic 12 did exist. It was not a mythological organization. And he said there were 6 civilians and 6 top security. Yes, he said also that the Project Blue Book does still continue. Yes, there was a Montauk Project. Yes, there was a Philadelphia experiment. They are pulling the cover off this, but this is the year supposed to happen. Meanwhile, they knew that Osiris was going to come back from the Orion Star constellation. That he had joined the Anunnaki in Orion. And that's why in your Bible it says, our Father who art in heaven. And in Greek, the word for heaven is Orionos. And when Jesus said, thy kingdom come to earth, he was speaking about crafts coming to earth. In my Father's house, there are many mansions. I'm going there to prepare a place for you. Not a state. He was going to a place. A place that, as the other brother was asking, a place that the devil visited humbly in the book of Job. The devil went to a place to talk to God along with other angels. And God obviously wasn't sitting on one throne, because somewhere in the book of Job, read it, the devil and God had a private discourse about how they're going to mess up Job's life just to test his faith. Something that God should have already known. Right. He should have known if Job was going to fall or not if he died. So the devil was able to go to a place where God and knew for Allah, for Jesus' father, Abba, was. You hear me? And visit that place. And
Osiris would return. How you think that Horus was born? You really think that Isis ran around finding body parts?
No.
No, and then when she found his penis, she said, he sat on it and gave birth to Horus? No. She sought out his body parts. And she found his what?
His.
Huh?
Go ahead.
His DNA.
With all the doctrine that's coming out and all the different things that you're doing little by little, you know, you have an effect on the people in a big way. You know what I'm saying? And you just got to be ready for it. Unfortunately, a lot of Nubians are not into computers like we are. And so they don't even know about the Hellbop. They don't even know, you don't know about the Hellbop, right? Comet. Right? A lot of people don't know about the Hellbop comet yet. And that's why I got a copy of the tape so they can hear the Amorites tell them about a craft like light, like entity that seems like it's alive, yet not alive, that's four times the size of Earth that they just discovered, and NASA is confirming it, that it's there, next to a meteorite that came into existence 2 years ago called Hellbop. And it's on the tape in there called Hellbop. And they're actually talking about this new craft thing, and they tell you it's coming towards Earth, and it's intelligently controlled, and it's coming to get a group of people. And they say on the tape that these group of people that they're coming to get are people that are involved in it, in advanced studies. And they literally say on the tape and say they're out to teach people. Did anybody hear it yet? Oh, you picked it up, right? Drop it in the car on the way back home. And listen to it. And the end of it, the guy says, in the beginning of it, in fact, he says, I'd like to thank Dr. So-and-so, something Malachi. That's not me now, right? It's somebody who uses the name Malachi. Most of them don't pronounce the name Malachi, they pronounce the name Malachi. Right? So it's a slip of tongue for them to say Malachi. That means they're letting us know where the source is, but they cannot deny. And we went into the computer and internet, and it showed us the comet. They had pictures of the comet in there, and it's good to know it's there. They know it's Nibiru. And they literally say on the tape, Zachariah Sitchin refers to this as Nibiru. Next came into us was, I tried to fax it to as many people as I can. I don't know if you got the skulls. Right? You got the skull? The skull of the jackal, the chromium twice the size. And right after that, about 2 days later, they sent us the skull of a teal. Cone, because everybody, when we said the cone is a real, people thought it was copying on Saturday Night Live. Of course, they don't know that everything the Amorite does, he puts the intelligence in front of you so you won't believe it. But they got actual skulls, and we're getting more information coming constantly because now that people know through the internet that we're the source of this information, they feel free sending us stuff.
So beings, crazy enough, beings from thousands of years ahead are coming back here trying to fix genetic defect. These beings are what you are going to look like in the future with the way the planet is moving. Namely, if the planet begins, the ice melts and the planet floods and people have to go beneath the water or a cave and they don't have exposure to the sun and the melanin starts to die, if you stick your hand in the water or stay in touch for a long time, where certain portions of the skin lift up so air, you know the reason why you got those wrinkles in your hand when you stay in touch too long is because it's creating buoyancy for you to float. In other words, air pockets going between it. That's why certain parts are up and certain parts are down. It's a scientific fact, investigate. You keep your hand in too long, the color will leave your hand. It's like when you put a band-aid on your hand, and keep the band-aid on too long, the melanin is gone, you turn pale gray, like gray. Alright? If you stare at the sun too long, your eyes change. And you lose the brown.
Yeah. telling you to. If you haven't had the experience, don't believe me. Say that nigga crazy. You have to have your own experience. How many people have had, I've done this before, it's a new class, how many people have had UFO experiences? Have seen them. They can't tell us they don't exist. They can fool some of the people some of the time, but they can't fool all of them. We had, I've seen them. The people here have been abducted. I'm telling you the truth, they play with you. They mess with you. But those who don't want to believe that, you know why? Your aura. You're so Christianized, so Muslimized, you're so spookized, that extraterrestrials can't even get to you. Because you got this blind faith. You think it's a protection. How do you know that the people like us that are being abducted are not being prepared for survival? How do you know that the contact they're making with us is because we're their children? They're great. They don't give a damn whether you're white or black. They abduct whoever they feel like. They're not caught up in the racism thing. You insecure bastards are. But any country you go from Africa to Europe, there's people being abducted. How do you not notice they're not selecting the 144 chosen ones? And if you haven't been abducted, maybe you're one that ain't gonna make it. They didn't expose themselves to you. Those of us that saw flying saucers or flying craft, saucers is a limited term, were supposed to see it. Those of us who had the experience, the confirmation, were supposed to have the experience. And if we don't have nothing in common, we all can sit in a room and say, you too, and have a certain fear inside this people. They can say, well, all y'all niggas are delusionary, y'all was under some massive hypnotic thing yet. Nobody bothers with that. Carter, they abducted his ass. Carter said, I see the flying saucers. President of the United States. We all love Jimi Hendrix, right? Most people did. He saw it. Well, my favorite artist, you know, David Bowie, always talks about seeing crap. Who's somebody? Paul McCartney. I can go on. Chevy Chase. If I said Ray Charles saw a flying saucer, now it's time to question what I'm talking about. If I say him and Stevie Wonder were together when they saw the flying saucer, now it's time to question what I'm talking about. I'm talking about confident, reliable, what they consider educated, tried and proven people saying it.
People kept talking about the wampiness in their belief in UFOs, and everybody in here is not supposed to accept UFOs. Only those in a show of hands who have had first-hand experience with extraterrestrials or crafts, raise your hand. See, all of us, we now know. Now what happens when you come across that same situation, when you have that same thing, you say to someone, I've seen a UFO, I've seen a gray, and they say, I don't believe you. You're basically what you say, what can I do? I gotta wait for you to get abducted. So all I gotta do is give you a warning of which ones apparently are dangerous, and virtue of the fact that they're dangerous to me, they might like you. They might beat me up and take you on a vacation to another galaxy. But you're not asked to believe in UFOs. You're asked, if you haven't had the experience, don't accept it. If they came to you and told you, we're about ready to come back and take over because the planet is messed up, so and so, and you go out and say, well, they're going to come back, they're going to call you a doomsday preacher. They're going to say you're nuts. They're going to say you're going to wait at the black permit for a craft to come. Why? Because it's not coming for them. But when they get into Plateist doctrine and start talking about a guy called Billy Myers way up in Europe who saw blonde hair, blue eyes, or the Unitarian Society in California that says a bunch of blonde hair, blue eyed, Nordic type creatures comes, or even Travis Walters who says, you know, when he got struck and was taken upon his craft, he woke up and a bunch of grays were looking at him, and in walks a tall blonde hair, blue eyed guy and takes him into another room, and next thing you know, he's been released. It is a subtle way of putting a belief system inside you in their favor. And if you ever go the other way, then Seals comes out and says, you're crazy. And all of the people who want to put the Platean concept in the air says, of course, them niggas got to be crazy for saying that. But it's all right when Billy Myers does it. He goes on television He got videotapes out. He's making millions and millions of dollars circulating that he had a visit when in Switzerland while on a mountainside tending the sheep with one arm, with a camera. A craft came to him, and he watched it, and then another one came, and another one. Next thing you know, they land, and out comes a girl and sits under a tree. Shade from another planet, but she thinks to sit under a tree for shade. She right away knows what trees can do on this planet. You know, but, you know, but they gave him, they scrutinized him first and pretended that they were going to be analytical to find out whether it was true or false, and it comes out, well, we can't say. We don't know when it comes to him. We don't know when it comes to the Unitarian Society. We don't know about Val Thor. They don't know. There's a certain Dr. Strange, right, who says he had direct contact with Valiant Thor from Venus. And he met him in the Pentagon. And he named the president, and the official was there. He got several books out explaining his involvement with these humanoids whose complexion was a little different. But they were humanoids, and they came from Venus. By the time they finish it, well, because they look close enough like us, then we don't know. You follow that? And then we have another group of people who said, well, in South Africa, a bunch of kids playing outside their schoolyard, they said a craft landed and they showed a symbol, similar to the symbol we used to show with the dome, the pyramid, and the lion through it, and they said this was on it. They had no access to our books. They said this symbol was on the craft, and out stepped four totally dark men, black men with long black thick hair and white robes, and looked at us. I got this on videotape, and looked at us, and all the kids described that these guys came out, looked at them, they got scared, they had a metallic craft, and they turned around and went back in the craft, took it away, they said these kids are lying. Huh. Why? A man in Puerto Rico says the same thing. He says he saw a craft land, and a man stood out, tall, dark-skinned man with a white robe, just looked at him, smiled, turned around, and got back in the craft, and it took off. Oh, he's lying. But the moment it becomes Nordic, it becomes believable. They even have moved their racism into the stars.
Everything I told you happened. Everything I told you to look for happened. This is not a place where people believe there's crafts. This is a place of people who saw the crafts. That's why we gathered here. We're not people who have a doubt of whether or not there's some extraterrestrial involvement. Our doubt was, how do we stay religious with the reality that there's extraterrestrial involvement and it's not mentioned in the books we say we believe in? That's where our problem came in. Our problem came into reality, faces, beliefs, and fictions. And as a devout Muslim my whole life, it was very difficult to flip open the Quran and scan and scan and scan and scan and don't see crafts. But I've seen crafts. Ain't no accident all across the country, all out the country. People see the same beings. Some little village in Switzerland that doesn't even have a radio station or a newspaper, and people are coming to town and saying, little 4 feet men with big eyes, and then over in Australia, and in Saudi Arabia, where it's a Kaaba, and millions of Muslims go make Salah every year, over there, people are seeing extraterrestrial crafts. Now, down in Gulf Breeze, New Mexico, then they push, this one place, Roswell, to take everybody's attention off the reality. Now they got everybody talking about Roswell and whether or not that's authentic, and what about the millions of sightings that are going on today? What about people that are being abducted and coming back and going under hypnosis and telling the same story, describing the same beings, saying they got the same treatment, they got scars on their bodies, probes taken out of their bodies, pictures of craft throughout Mexico. They actually shot back with home cameras. We had it on a film last weekend. And just thousands of people in Mexico just took pictures of metallic craft, stuff like this. Not lights zooming across the sky, but you could say, well, that could be this, could be a meteorite, could be this, could be Venus. Actual crafts. You understand? And then when you come back as a religious person with religious convictions to Christ, Muhammad, or whom, or whatever, and you don't find it in your holy book, and if you go to your reverend or your preacher or your pastor or your imam or your kohen and you ask them about it, they tell you you're crazy.
because you are a signaled out individual in your church who had the vision, who saw the craft. The majority of churches are so spooked out or so caught up in it they won't admit it, that you look like a nut. And the preacher can turn around and say, well, that kid there is a little strange. He thinks he sees little green men. The concept of the little green men are stamped in your head by the media, by television, by cinemas, by the movies, as you call it here in America. So that when I say I saw a little man, they say, you're a little green man, right? And I can't continue my story without looking like I'm crazy. You follow? So we're the people who've had the real experiences. People that know something is getting ready to happen. We're the people that are psychic sensitive. We feel something ain't right in the air. Regardless of whether we were Christians, Rastafarians, Muslims, Jews, Catholics, whatever we were brainwashed into, we took the time to investigate our own feelings and set aside our beliefs.
I am with Papa Show and Papa Hood. Okalala Show, Kawan Jewett's name. I am with Kasamon and Papa Hood. Papa Hood, Kawan Kasamon, Ebony. I am with Papa Hood. Papa Hood, Kawan Wap, Amani. Zako Kador.